I welcome you all in the next video tutorial of Pharmacognosy and Phytochemistry 1. So dear all, in this video, as you can see, we will going to cover a very important topic of pharmacognosy, that is the marine drugs. Just see the syllabus. In the unit number 5, we are going to cover the marine drugs, that is the novel medicinal agents from the marine sources. So first of all, just enjoy some of the beautiful photographs related to the marine drugs. As you can see in your screen, this is a sea sponge. Here it is, the tunicates, very important marine organism, and is the source of the, or you can say the potential source of the, some of the immense phyto or the marine constituents. This is a seaweed, very important sources of different compounds. We will do the structure also in detail in the later section of this video. This is the red algae, blue green algae, brown algae. So there are different kind of algae that is used in the marine pharmacognosy. Yes, sea star is there, very important source of drug. Sea snail, dinoflagellates, these are included under the marine microorganisms. So marine microorganisms play a very critical role in maintaining the ecosystem of the marine, as well as they also act as a sources of different compounds. Seashells, yes, source of the calcium carbonate. These are the important phytoconstituents that are isolated from the marine drugs, marine sources like bryostatin, saxitoxin, dolostatin, etc. So now let's start the topic. Yes, marine as sources of drugs. As you can see, the marine pharmacognosy is a sub branch of pharmacognosy, which is mainly concerned with the naturally occurring substances of the medicinal value from the marine. And we know oceans cover more than 70% of the earth's surface, and they are source of different type of organism, in from invertebrates to the different microorganism, etc. So it is not the new era for the pharmacognosy. Different civilizations like Greek, Japan, China, and even the Indian civilization have used marine as source of drugs. If you talk about the Western medicine, the agar, alginic acid, carrageenan, protamine sulfates, permacetin, these are the very famous products in the Western medicine also. Now we will focus upon the classification. The classification of the marine drugs on the basis of the action, and second is the on the basis of the organism. So we will focus upon the classification based upon the organism. That is the first classification. तो marine drugs को marine pharmacognosy में दो तरह से classification पढ़ेंगे. First classification होगी on the basis of the organism, किस तरह के organism जो marine में हमें मिलते हैं, जिनसे हम drugs obtain करते हैं, हमने उस तरह उनको classify किया गया. दूसरी classification में हम करेंगे on the basis of the action, उन marine organism से जो हम compound निकाल रहे हैं, उनका क्या pharmacological action होगा, उन compounds की क्या activity होगी, उसके बेसिस पे हमने उसको क्लासिफाई करेंगे. तो फर्स्ट क्लासिफिकेशन, दैट इज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिज्म. यस, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन सम ऑफ द फोटोग्राफ्स ऑफ द मैराइन ऑर्गेनिज्म्स. द स्पॉन्जेस आर देयर, ट्यूनिकेट्स, सीवीड्स एंड द मैराइन माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म्स. एंड इफ वी क्लासिफाई द मैराइन ड्रग्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द एक्शन, दे आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू फॉलोइंग टाइप्स लाइक एंटी माइक्रोबियल कंपाउंड्स. तो वी ऑब्टेन एंटी माइक्रोबियल कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स फ्रॉम मैराइन ऑर्गेनिज्म्स. Antiviral compounds, cytotoxic, cardiovascular and neuropsychological compounds, also neurophysiological compounds. Anti-inflammatory compounds also isolated from different marine organisms, as well as enthalmintic and prostaglandins. So you have to remember the classification of the marine drugs on the basis of the two, that is the first one is on the basis of the organism, and second is the on the basis of its action. So we will start with the first classification, that is based upon the organism. So we'll start with the sponge. The first one is a sponge. As you know, sponge are studied because of their wealth of the metabolites, and these are filter feeding animals. So let's see the photograph of sponge. As you can see, these are the photographs of sea sponge. So sea sponge, these are the source of different chemicals that we are using, still using in the pharmaceutical as well as in the modern sciences. The second one is the tunicates, that is the urochordata, sometimes known as the tunicata and also known as the sea squids. So you have to remember about tunicates, they are known as the sea squids. And basically these tunicates arise from the existence of the tunic, and this tunic is attached to substrate. It has two opening, inhalant siphon and exhalant siphon. The tunic shape is there, just see the image. Yes, in tunicates two openings are there, as you can see here. This is the oral siphon and this is the atrial siphon. So this type of organism having a particular shape is known as the tunic shape. Please see here, this one, two openings are there. This one first opening and this is the second one. Please see, these are the photographs of the sea squid. Here it is, this is the sea squid. So we will go with the next classification, next type in the on the basis of the organism is the seaweeds. So as we have seen some of the photographs, so we have blue green algae, green algae, brown as well as the red algae. So cyanophygi, that is the blue green algae, chlorophyce, that is the green algae, phacophyce is the brown, and the rhodophyce is the red algae. So the seaweeds refer to the large marine algae that grow almost exclusively in the shallow waters at the edge of the world's ocean. So you have to remember this thing. These are found in the shallow waters at the edge of the oceans. So they provide home and food for different sea animals. As you know, seaweeds, they are also the home for different marine organisms, as well as they have different industrial applications also. And they basically use sun energy to produce carbohydrates for their food. So just see the photograph of some of the seaweeds now. So you have to remember this structure also, structure of the seaweed. This is the structure of the seaweed. So as you can see, different components, different parts are there, like blades, float, stipe and hold fast. So the main important component that is present in the structure is this one. As you can see, let me show you, this is the seaweed. As you can see over here, this is the bubbler shaped structure. So this one is known as the nematocytes, that is the gas filled bladders. So this is filled with the carbon dioxide gas, which help the seaweed to float. Okay, so it also has the blades, like its leaf like portion, and the thallus is known as the complete plant. So remember this one, this is a structure, there is bladder, it is filled with the carbon dioxide which help the seaweeds to float in the sea or oceans. Next one is the marine microorganisms. So we are using or exploring different organism or the microorganism pertaining to the ocean for our drug discovery procedure. So after the discovery of the penicillin, attention has been focused on searching from the terrestrial microorganism to the sources of the marine. Please see some of the examples of the marine drugs. That is from the organism. We have to focus upon the organism because this is our first classification. So from sea star, we isolate saponins, and it is used as a cardiovascular drug. And from the algae, we obtain decatetranoic acids. So these are used as an anti-inflammatory drug. And from snail, we obtain conotoxin, used in the CNS. Then from the dinoflagellates, saxitoxin is obtained. Again from the sponge, tunicates, from tunicate, dolastatin 10 is a compound which is used as an antifungal. And from the algae, tetrahydrofuran has been isolated. It is used again as an enthalmintic drug. So these are the some important compounds isolated from the marine organism that have a potential physiological action or role. Again, there is a list of some marine products. For example, from the marine sponge, ERA-A is a product that is obtained from the marine sources, and mostly from the sponge. It has application in the antiviral. ERA-C, again anti-cancer. Cephalosporins from the marine fungi, used as antibiotic. Laminarin from sea squids, used as immunomodulator. And from again from sea squids, a compound that is known as the bryostatin is used as an anti-cancer. This is the structure of bryostatin, bryostatin 1, then saxitoxin, and this is the structure of the dolostatin. These all are obtained from the marine organisms. This is laminarin. So far we have completed the first classification, that is on the basis of the organism. We have completed sponge, tunicates, seaweeds and marine microorganisms. So let's focus upon the second classification. Yes, on the basis of the action, that is from antimicrobial compounds isolated from the marine, antiviral, cytotoxic, cardiovascular, anti-inflammatory and helminthic and prostaglandins. So first classification is the antimicrobial compounds from the marine sources. So you have to remember one important compound, that is cephalosporin C. I hope you remember about this antibiotic. This is obtained from marine fungus, and this is the name of a fungus, that is the Cephalosporium acermonium, and from this we have isolated cephalosporin C. So this is a fungus, that is the acermonium. Please see the structure of the cephalosporin C. This is the antibiotic obtained from the marine fungus, that is cephalosporin C. So you have to remember the structure also. So the second compound that you have to remember is the istamycins. So what is istamycin? So these are the fermented products of the marine microorganism, and you have to remember the name also, that is the Streptomyces langiomariensis. This is the compound, that is the istamycin. And these compounds are reported to have, yes, in vitro activity against gram positive and gram negative bacteria. Inka action kya hai? Antimicrobial. Kiske against? Gram positive or gram negative bacteria against. Next compound. So the next important compound in the category of the antimicrobial is the zonarol or isozonarol. So you have to remember these names also, zonarol and isozonarols. So it is obtained from the brown algae, that is Dictyotaris zonaroids, and it is having antifungal activity. So it is very important antifungal compound, zonarol and isozonarol. So this is the brown algae from which we have obtained zonarol and isozonarol compounds. Next antimicrobial compound that you have to remember is the tetrabromoheptanone. So it is obtained from the red algae. So now let's start the antiviral compounds. So in antivirals, anti-HIV compounds have been isolated from the lamiranin species from the brown algae, and it is reported to have a anti-HIV and anticoagulant activity. Like say for example, ERA A is a compound, it is a semisynthetic compound isolated from the sponge, that is the Tetiha crypta. So this is the sea sponge. Please see the structure of ERA A. This is the structure of ERA A. You have to remember the structure also. So the second antiviral compounds are Everol and Everone. So these compounds have been isolated again from the sponge, that is the Dicidia avara. So they inhibit the HIV virus, that is the immunodeficiency virus. So these are the anti-HIV, or we can say the antiviral compounds isolated from the sponge. Please see the photograph. This is the Dicidia avara. So this one is the Everol and this is the Everone. Next important antiviral compound is the Eudistomin A and beta carbolins. So these are obtained from the tunicates, that is the Eudistoma ovatium. So yes, this is the Eudistoma. Eudistoma, very important tunicate. So next one are the cytotoxic compounds from the marine. So the large number of compounds have been isolated from the marine organism. And these are very important because they are used in different type of treatment of different type of cancers. They are cytotoxic compounds obtained from the marine, like bryostatins. It is obtained from Pugula neritina. Please see the image of beautiful micro. This is beautiful marine organism, that is the Pugula neritina. Look at this. Next important cytotoxic compound is the dolostatins. So these are obtained from the sea hare, that is Dolabella auricularia. So you have to remember this marine organism, that is the Dolabella auricularia, from which dolostatin have been isolated and it is reported to be cytotoxic. Yes, we are talking about this Dolabella auricularia. that is the sea hare. So next important compound are the zinnia. It is obtained from the coral, that is the zinnia elongata, and also the nepthia. It is also obtained from the coral, and they both reported to be active against the cancer cell. So these are the cytotoxic zinnia and nepthia obtained from the corals like zinnia elongata. Look at this beautiful image of the coral zinnia. Look at this. This is the zinnia coral. So from this cytotoxic compound have been isolated. Next is the aplidin. So it is obtained from the marine organism, that is a tunicate, Aplidium albicans. So from Aplidium albicans, aplidin is obtained. It is used against thyroid carcinoma. So very, very important. Let's see, this is Aplidium. So next one is the Era C and Era A. So these are again very important compounds obtained from the sponge. So now let's see some of the cardiovascular and the neurophysiological compounds obtained from the marine. So the important cardiovascular agent obtained from marine is the enthoplurine A. So it is a heart stimulating processing activity obtained from the sea anemone, that is the Anthopleura xanthogrammica. So here it is, the photograph of the Anthopleura xanthogrammica. Next important cardiotonic agent obtained from the marine, octopus, that is from the octopus vulgaris, octopus macropus, and the name of the compound is D-octopamine. It is very, very important. It is obtained from the salivary gland of the octopus. So next is the alpha syntotoxin, then inotoxin, conotoxin. So these are also very, very important cardiovascular agents and also used in the neurodegenerative disorders like Parkinson's disease. Say for example, alpha conotoxin is used in the Parkinson's disease as a muscle relaxant and also in the antihypertensive and analgesic. Next one is the anti-inflammatory. So the pseudoterosins are the important anti-inflammatory agents obtained from different Caribbean octocorals. Like, say for example, which type of compounds are they? Pseudoterosins 1 and seco pseudoterosins 3. So they have anti-inflammatory property. So next one is the monolide. It is again very important non-steroidal anti-inflammatory compound. It is obtained from the marine sponge, that is the Lufalaria genus. This is the Lufalaria. So next we will focus upon the enthelminthic compounds obtained from the marine sources. So some important enthelminthic agents include canic acid and domoic acid. So these are very, very important enthelminthic compounds obtained from the marine sources, like say for example, obtained from the red algae, Digenia simplex, and it is also very, very active against tapeworm infection also. Next, anticoagulants are also there, like carrageenan. Okay, from anticoagulants, example is the acanthophora obtained from the red algae, that is the laminarian. And second example is the carrageenan. It is obtained from different species of the chondrus and it has anticoagulant activity. So last we have prostaglandin. So you have to remember one important coral, that is the Plexura homomala, from which different prostaglandins have been isolated. And we know prostaglandins, they constitute a very diverse biologically active compounds that have wide spectrum. It causes contraction and relaxation of the smooth muscles of the uterus, cardiovascular system and the intestinal along with the bronchial tissue. And they also inhibit the gastric secretion and control the blood pressure and suppress the blood platelet aggregation. So they have, PGs have a very diverse role in the body. So I hope this is clear. So we have completed, yes, marine as sources of the drugs. So we have completed two classification based upon the organism, sponges, tunicates, seaweed and the marine microorganisms, as well as on the basis of the action, in which we have studied about different important bioactive compounds, like they are using as antimicrobial, antiviral, cytotoxic, cardiovascular and the neurophysiological, as well as anti-inflammatory, enthelmintic and prostaglandins. So I hope this is clear to you. So in the last, I acknowledge all the sources I have used to prepare this video. So this video is for education purpose only, no commercialization is involved. So I respectfully acknowledge all the sources that I have used to prepare this video. So thank you very much for your patience and listening. See you in the next lecture.